Alright guys, I'm Odin from Tactical Edge Hobbies here at G-Bung Store, and today we're going to carry on the second part of our pistol maintenance video where we go in and we actually go through a Glock this time. I did the high capper last time. If you haven't seen that video yet, jump in our channel, go back and have a look at it. We go right through on what you need to do to maintain, and today we're going to do the same thing on the Glock, and we've also got some magazine tips in there as well for you. So let's get into it, pull apart and see how we maintain your stuff.
Okay, so moving to our Glock type variant pistols. You'll always want to remove the mag and set that aside. Now, the hammer on a Glock is internal. It lives in here. If that is raised when you try to take the slide off, it's going to catch it. So with the Glock variants, always slide the slide to the back first. Now that's reset the hammer down. Then you want to grab this little pull tab on this side and this one on this side at the same time. So you're trying to achieve that and pull them both down a little bit. And then the slide will push forward. And that is it, it's now released. You can now take your slide off. If you don't rack the slide back before you go to take it off, and this hammer assembly here, as you can see, is poking up, that will stop your slide from coming off. All you need to do is rack the slide backwards and that will stay back down. We'll set the slide to the side, grab our microfiber cloth, start wiping out any of the excess grease or leftover grease from previous, and start looking for those shiny metal spots where we've had metal on metal contact wear. So looking at this Glock, it's in very good condition. We have some tiny little bits back here, completely normal, matching marks here, and some marks along here. The high areas on these rails are designed for wear. It's accepted that there's going to be a certain amount of wear in a pistol's lifetime. What we're trying to achieve by proper lubrication is to extend that lifetime and the performance of the pistol as best we can. I'm quite happy with that, so we'll set that aside. Now, with the slides and the upper, on the Glocks, to remove the recoil spring and guide rod, you simply grab hold of it and it'll pop out at the back and you just pull it back. The barrel, slide it forward, and then just grab that from in there and slide it out on an angle. Set that down over here. And again, we're just gonna grab our microfiber cloth and we're gonna wipe off any of the old lubricant and look for any wear. Now, being a black slide, this makes looking for wear extremely easy because it's a contrasting color. Now, I'm not seeing a lot of wear there at all. We have some wear along here, which is quite common. That's where our mag catch actually slides before it catches and holds the slide back when we have an empty magazine. We've got a little bit of wear on our blowback unit here where the disconnectors ride, and that's completely normal. There's no gouging of the metal or anything like that. It's just nice and shiny where it's rubbed the coating off. And our nozzle snapping back nicely. And it's moving freely. There's no junk around that nozzle. So from here, we'll grab our silicone spray, pull the nozzle forward, bit of a squirt through the port, and then again along the sides of the piston just to give it a bit of a hand. And we'll take our rag and we'll wipe that down. Quite simply. Then we grab our paintbrush and our lubricant. A little bit will do ya. And we just paint the inside of the rails. Exactly the same as we did on the high capper. All we're looking for is a nice even coating, again, of a good synthetic lubricant with something like a PTFE modifier in there to help stop any wear of the metal. And as you can see, it works quite well. So with these pistols having around 50 mags each through them, you would expect to see significant wear. However, in this instance, because we've had it well lubricated and maintained, the wear has happened to the lubricant, not to the pistol. So the pistol is still in very good condition. Your barrel, the inner barrel does slide straight out like that. So you want to make sure that that's put all the way in and forward. And that just angles in the same way as it came out. Drop it in and push it back from the front until it seats, and just move your inner back just that little bit there. So the inner barrel will move back just a touch, and that's fine. As far as maintenance with the spring and the guide rod, again, we want to make sure that it's nice and clean. We don't want to cake it up with too much lubricant because it can affect the performance and the longevity of it. In this instance, I'm going to leave that exactly as is. It has a very slight film of the silicon oil on it. So I'm happy with that. Pop that back in, so you put the front in first, it will locate like so, and then push the rod through, sits it back into the position there, and there. And as you saw, when I sat that back in the position, it actually pushed our inner all the way to the rear, exactly like it's supposed to. We go back to our lower, we grab our lubricant and our brush again, even less this time because we only have some small sections of rails. So as you can see, on the Glock variant at the front, you actually only have these bits. These rails here don't actually contact with the slide, it's only these front sections here, so a bit of lubricant on those, all the way around. It is important to try and get lubricant underneath the rails, in and along here, because they are metal on metal contact areas as well, and they're a bit harder to see, so it's always best to try and just run your paintbrush underneath the rail. Alright, that'll do for the front rails. Again, we're just looking to cover the metal area where the slide's going to rub underneath the rail on the top. Now, something I didn't do on the high capper, which you can do it on any of your pistols, is if you just grab a little bit, and I do mean a little bit of silicone oil, and down inside your hammer group here, just give it a little bit of either a drop or a quick squirt. There, I got my hand, and then just wipe off any extra. All we're trying to do there is just to get a small amount of lubrication into the hammer group back in here, which has all the movement for the moving components to make it fire. Now, that's done. In fact, I've probably over lubricated that a little bit. Just give it a clean up with my finger. So that gives you a bit of an idea of how much lubricant you would expect once you've completely re-lubricated your Glock pistol. So from here, the hammer is down, grab our slide, line the rails up, like so, on, all the way back, and then bring it forward. And just make sure it's locked in, give it a bit of a pull forward, it shouldn't come forward at all. And then, wipe off any excess lubricant, and that is how you maintain your Glock. Now, we'll move on to the mags. Hang on to magazines. Generally speaking, with magazines, they don't take a lot of maintenance. You don't really want to start pulling them apart because you will damage O-rings. The only time you would want to do that is if you had a leak, for example. So this one is a Glock type magazine, and we have a high capper type magazine here. I'll set the Glock one aside as they are very much the same, and I'll just use this one for our demonstration. So first of all, grab your microfiber cloth, give the outside a bit of a wipe down. Have a look at the magazine feed lips. There shouldn't be any chunks missing or chips or anything like that. I'd recommend checking that every time you go and play. Pull your follower down, check the gel channel through there. Occasionally you can get buildup of debris in there, so just get a small brush and clean that out, or toothpick will do the job quite nicely as well. With maintenance, there's not much more than that you need to do. You can give these a bit of a wet wipe down with a wet cloth. It won't cause them any damage whatsoever. The only other area you might want to disassemble to check would be the base plate. So to remove the base plate, just use a small tool. I have a pin punch handy here. You push down the spring-loaded detent, and that will then want to slide forward. And you'll have to do it again on some of these where you have the green gas port as well. And the base plate will now slide off. These are interchangeable. Tactical Edge Hobbies now stock multiple different aluminium bases for the high capper magazines, and they are relatively easy to swap out, as you just saw. Now, for maintaining the valves inside your magazine, you are going to need some tools. As you just saw, I used a small pin punch to remove the magazine base, and you will also need some valve keys. In this instance, I have valve keys that are individual little tools. So this one here with the very small fit that has two wings, one on either side, that there is specifically designed for installing and removing these valves. Now, if you do have a leak here, what you can do to try and stop that before deciding whether or not you need a replacement valve is simply put that in, unscrew the fill valve, pull it all the way unscrewed, and you'll feel it jump on the thread, and just grab hold of it and pull it out. Now, typically, if you're going to be removing one of these, it's usually to replace it. You can grease the O-rings, which can help sealing in some instances. I would again recommend the use of a synthetic lubricant on that. In this case, I'm going to use a little bit of the same synthetic lubricant that I've been using on the slides, as I have some on my brush, And when it comes to O-rings, less is more. You basically want the O-ring to be wet if you don't want excess grease. So we should do the paint. And that's it, that is done. Now there is another small O-ring down in there that can be lost at times. Replacements for those can be difficult, but the full valves are usually an easier part to track down. However, with the proper care when using your full valves, it's not something that you will need to worry about because they do last an exceptional amount of time. Then we just simply reinsert it back into the hole, grab our fill valve tool, and screw it back. Now when you're screwing these in, you don't want to go 8, okay? Once they go tight, so that's tight now, I'll give it maybe another little touch up and that's it, done. It has an O-ring on it. O-rings do the sealing work for you. So when you squash an O-ring, it'll do its best to fill in every little nook and cranny that it possibly can. The only other valve we have is the, of course, the discharge port. So to remove that, you'll need this type of a tool, a large round flat face with the two little tabs. You simply drop that in the hole over the stem and unscrew it. Now again, it's fairly rare that you would want to remove these. If you do, you do run the risk of damaging the O-rings. However, if you do have a faulty one, we do have spares and they are very simple to replace. So you simply flip it over, tap it out, and there's your fill valve. Now, as you can see, you do have a series of O-rings on the fill valves. The discharge valves. This is not a fill valve, we've already covered that. You have main O-ring, and then you have two further towards the front. So all I'll do again, as I said previously, less is more on O-rings. So we'll just give it a nice little coating. Just so they look a little bit shiny. I didn't even put any more on the brush there. I'm just using what's left over from when I did the pistol. And then simply drop it back down into the hole. And you want it to fall in there nice and freely. Grab your tool, sit it on the back, and then what I always recommend with these, because they're a brass thread going into a different metal body, do counterclockwise a little bit. And you'll actually feel once you go past the threads, it ticks a little bit, and now actually the tool has sat much more level in the mag. We then tighten that down. And this is another one where you don't want to go too tight. Too tight will cause the O-rings to deform and can actually decrease the amount of gas that can flow through the magazine. So firm and a little bit more and that's it, we're done. Now I can put my magazine base plate back on. Simply push down the little spring detent there with the base plate, slide it on. It will catch on the green gas port. Push it down and there we go. And then if it doesn't snap back, you simply push it from the front and it will. Now, green gas. There is multiple different types of green gas on the market. Some comes with lubricant pre-installed, some doesn't. All that means is that in these cans of gas, there is an amount of silicone oil in there. It's the same type of silicone oil that we sell in our little Trident bottles. And its design is to get inside the magazine, and every time you fire that, it will travel through the discharge port on the top, into the blowback unit, and it will help lubricate your air seals. That's all this will do. It won't take away any of your maintenance requirements. It just helps lubricate your gas or air or gas seals as it works its way through the system. Some green gases we've noted seem to have less lubricant, others seem to have more. What you can do in the instance where you have a green gas that has very little or no lubricant, and the easiest way to determine that is after you've used the magazine, if you have a look at the top of the magazine where this gasket is here and it's completely dry, then you're not getting much lubricant come through. What I would recommend in that case is simply grab a bottle of silicone oil, and you just put one little drop straight down on top of the fill valve, and then you get your green gas and you fill the magazine. Like so. Alright, now I would recommend that you only do that once every 4 or 5 magazine fills. It doesn't need to be a lot. Again, all the lubricant in these tins is supposed to be doing, or the lubricant that you may have just added to the rear stem, is lubricate the air seals inside the pistol. It's not there to try and lubricate any of the metal components. It's not there to try and lubricate the slide. It's purely to help you get a better gas seal to make your pistol perform better. All right. Now, obviously, WeTech Green Gas does come with a good quality silicon lubricant in it, and I've also then added lubricant on top here, so I've technically over lubricated this mag. That's not a problem, it's nothing to be concerned with. I'm just going to have to be conscious that for the first few times this magazine's used, I'm going to need to pull it out, give it a clean, and also perhaps pull the slide off the pistol and just wipe any excess built up oil there. As far as filling mags, one more thing here that I'll show you just quickly as a bit of a custom shop pro tech tip. When you find that you're getting less and less shots out of your green gas magazine, you know, on average we see around 20 to 25 shots, you'll slowly see that start to decline. Now, what that is, it's when there's a buildup of gas inside here that's not green gas. Now, all of these cans do have other gases in them, which is usually air, nitrogen, things like that. Nothing harmful, but it will build up in here and it will decrease the capacity for your green gas. So the way that we purge that out is we start off by pointing the mag away from us, depressing the rear button, make sure there's no gas inside at the moment, or nothing under pressure at least. Then the way I do it, and I have fairly large hands, so you may need two people to do this yourself, but I use my little finger to depress the valve in the back, just like that. And then you simply fill the magazine, pointing it down until you see a white vapor cloud start to come out discharge port, and then remove your little finger and continue to fill the magazine. Now what that'll do, that any of the other gases, so they call it, that build up in here, that'll flush them out, push them straight out there, and you'll have nothing but green gas left in your magazine, and you'll get the best shots per fill out of it. I do it fairly regularly. It helps a lot of people out. Give it a try. All right, well, I hope that helps you understand a little bit better the maintenance requirements for your gas blowback pistol. If there's any questions you've got or something I haven't addressed you were looking for in this video, please get in touch with us. We have techs at Yatla, Mount Gravatt, and of course, myself at G-Bung. Jump online and see us on Facebook. We have a Discord channel that I'll drop a link in the description below. Get in touch with us. We'll help you out. We'll even help you pick the right performance improvements for your pistol to achieve your playing style. As always, guys, I'm Odin, this is Tactical Edge Hobbies, and this has been our Tuesday Tech Talk brought to you by The Custom Shop. Get out there, play some gel ball, have some fun.